After this video, you will be able to make your WordPress website truly accessible, ensuring your site is usable for the 2.5 billion people that use assistive technology, and making sure you comply with the European Accessibility Act. Make sure to watch to the end of this video, because I have a surprise giveaway. To get the free plugin, we go to wp.discount/ally. This link is also in the description of this video and in the comment section. And then we are at the website of Ally, created by Elementor. It's a web accessibility plugin that really works very well with all kinds of websites, even if you don't use Elementor on your WordPress website. So we click over here on Get It Free. And then Ally has four different plans. I'm going to explain those plans to you later on this video when I'm going to upgrade to the standard version. For now, the free version will be enough for one website and 10,000 visits a month. So let's press over here on Get It Free. Then we first need to log in or register with Elementor. Don't worry, it's completely free, as you can see. So make sure to do that. I'm just going to press on Sign In. And then we press over here, Start Free Trial. Then we press over here, Download Zip. Log into your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP Admin,
that's not
a very safe way, so please watch my tutorial over here so you don't get hacked. Then we go over here to Plugins, Add Plugin. Press on Upload Plugin, and then select the plugin we've just downloaded from Elementor. It's called poyoaccessibility.zip. Don't worry, it's still the right file, but it has to do with the very first versions of Elementor was the Poyo theme. But that's way back, but that's the way WordPress and all the update system work. So it's the right file. Then we press on Install Now. After that, we press on Activate Plugin. Great. Then we go over here to Get Started. Then hit this blue button over here. And then again, we need to sign in with Elementor. If you want to help the developers, then keep this checked. And then press Approve and Connect. And then we click on this blue button, Done. We're going to talk about all these options over here, so you know exactly how to set up and what this plugin actually really does. First of all, we are at the Design tab, and we can change the style of our icon. Choose different icons, but I like this one the best. You can also change the size of it, the corner radius to perfectly match your website. Well, we are using on this website, we are using 10 pixels in all the corners, so that's way better for my site. And then we can change the color. I was hoping that our global colors were over here. I don't know why it's not integrated, because it's also from Elementor, so that will be something they can approve. But we're going with the accent color, which is this one, and this blends in perfectly with my website, as you will see in just a moment. And then we scroll down and we can change the position of the icon. You can change it on mobile and on desktop. But remember, wherever you place this icon, if someone clicks on it, the widget will open in the right bottom corner. So I'm just going with the bottom right. Seems like the logic position. And you can also change the exact position to make it pixel perfect. In here, we can hide it on desktop. I don't know why you want that, but it's possible. And on mobile, you can also place it somewhere else and change the exact position. After this, we press Save Changes. Then over here, we have the capabilities, because this widget is actually, it's a little bit modular. You can disable and enable all these features that you want to have inside of your widget. I would suggest to keep everything on, because all these features are really useful if you have disabilities. Also activate the sitemap function, and you go over here and change this URL to /sitemap.xml, or the one provided with your SEO plugin, which is also very useful. If someone just clicks over here, they can navigate through your sitemap. Going to demonstrate it in just a second. All these features and capabilities I will be showing you in just a second on the front end. It's really nice. Then also, you can hide the Ally by Elementor logo, but only in the pro version. I'll be upgrading to that one in just a second. Then you can also skip to the main content. Some screen readers make use of this with the keyboard, so just keep it enabled. Then press Save Changes, and we scroll up and we go over here to the statement. you need an accessibility statement just like the cookie policy and the privacy policy generator. By the way, I do have a nice video about that privacy policy generator, if you're interested. For now, we click over here on Yes, I need one. Press on Continue. Then fill in your company name, website, and business email. And make sure that your business email is an email that works, because it's mandatory that people with a disability can contact you for problems with your accessibility widget. All right, after that, we press on Create Statement and Page. Now, we went ahead and linked the accessibility statement page you just created with your widget. Great, just keep it like this. There's also an option in here to hide the entire link. I would not advise you to activate that. Then we go over here to the analytics. If you've upgraded to a pro version, you can actually see if people use the widget, so you can justify the cost or just cancel your subscription. And the last thing I want to show you in here is the visits per month. And those are limited in the free plan to 10,000 visitors per month. How is that being calculated? Good question. Each IP or device within 24 hours is one visitor. Just like that. If you need more visitors, you need to upgrade your plan. I'll be doing that in just a second, so you can show exactly how that works. But first, let's see how this accessibility plugin works on the front end of our website. As you can see on my beautiful e-commerce website, which you of course can follow my 5.5 hours tutorial to create this beautiful e-commerce Elementor Pro tutorial with all these stock images completely for free. You can follow this tutorial over there and I'll show you exactly how it works. But we're not talking about that one. We are talking about the accessibility plugin. There is my beautiful icon, and if you click on it, this will open up. It's fairly huge on my screen, which is a good thing. Let me show you quickly what those things are. You can make the text bigger, and when you click on it, you have four options to actually change the size to really big. Now, this is just perfect because my design doesn't break. Everything still works. Not everything I see. Those numbers, well, they need to improve it because it doesn't work nice. Maybe in the next version, they will fix it when I've sent them my video. But for the rest, this worked really great, except for these form fields. Interesting. They should also change that one. Then the next one is the bigger line height. If you click on this one, then we have more space between the lines. Very useful when you're on a blog or when you visit individual products. Look at this. It works really great. Then there's also an option to text align it on the left side or on the right side. And you can see how this works over here. Click once, it will be aligned to the left side. Click twice, it will be aligned to the right side. And again, it's just normal. Then we can change all the fonts on our website to a more readable font. As you can see, this really is more rounded font. And my normal font is just a bit difficult to read. So I can understand that people will use this feature on this website, why not? Then we also have grayscale. When you click on it, everything just turns into black and white. Very nice. Then the contrast option is also great. We have the dark contrast. As you can see, everything now is dark, but also my background images are completely gone. We have the light contrast, black and white, works perfectly. High contrast, really easy to read, but now all my background images of my sections are gone. But I think that's exactly the purpose of this function. And we also have the high contrast. You can see now that all the links are being underlined. Then over here, we have the page structure. If you click on this one, you can see all the H tags in your website and people can navigate through them clicking on this. That's what it's supposed to be. Can be useful, I think. I don't know, I've never used it before. Then over here we have the sitemap functionality. If someone clicks on it, a new screen will pop up and you can go to the XML sitemap generated by your SEO plugin, or in this case, just by WordPress itself. And then we have a really neat feature, the reading mask. If you click on it, you can still interact with the website. So close this one, scroll all the way up, for example. And this is the way it actually works. What I am missing in here is just a functionality to get a magnifying glass. That would be very nice. Maybe it's here in the outline focus, we'll see. Then we go to the next option, which is hide the images. Now this can be useful, but when I click on it, you see that none of my images that are backgrounds in my containers are being removed, but my normal image widgets are being removed. I think this is something they still need to build in, as the background of my containers are still producing images. This next button is to pause any animations on your website. If I enable this, it stops working. Now that's great. The animation stops working, but the functionality is still there. So I can still move this one, but if I enable it, you can see that it's a little bit smoother. Also, when I scroll down, I have these beautiful animations. Also with this one, just a transform option, CSS, nothing fancy, just a little bit growing. And if I pause my animations, it's still growing, so the functionality is there, but it doesn't show any animations. Could be useful. Then over here we have the outline focus. I was hoping to see a magnifying glass, but on my website it's not doing anything. Not by selecting it, not by pressing a button on my keyboard. So I don't know exactly what the functionality of this thing is, and I couldn't find it online. So if you know, drop it down in the comments, and I'm glad to learn. Then the last option over here before we upgrade to the pro version is the highlight links. If you click on this, actually all the links are being highlighted. Wow, this is so clear. I really like this. And it's perfectly fine because this one is not a link, but it's a drop down. I didn't put any links in here. And this one just here. Well, this works great. For a free plugin, this is not bad at all. This is actually my go-to web accessibility plugin from now on, because you get so much for free. I like it. Then we also have another feature over here, which is called reset all the settings. Just press this button once and everything will be back to normal. We also have this option, hide widget. If you click on it, you can hide the entire accessibility widget for this session, 24 hours or a week. Why is this important? Well, you might not want to see this little icon somewhere on the website, but also in the near future when the Accessibility Act is going live, there will be some browser extensions created that will automatically disable accessibility widget buttons and icons because you don't need them. So they might make use of this functionality. All right, let's upgrade to the pro version and let me show you how that works. To upgrade your subscription, go back to WordPress, click on Analytics, and go over here to Upgrade Now. Then what I want to do, I want to upgrade to the standard plan because I want to have one website. 25,000 visits a month sounds great. I have the white label and the screen reader, but also some awesome features are coming soon. For example, the scan and monitor. It will regularly scan our website to detect accessibility issues and track our changes over time throughout our website. Very great. Let's not forget also the scanner, a centralized panel displaying detected accessibility issues, their severity, and actionable insights for improvement. So we can do that on the back end of our website. And last but not least, the remediation flow. And it provides a list of identified accessibility issues with tools and recommendations to fix them, including options for automatic corrections. Now, these things are really top-notch. I cannot demonstrate you right now because they're not entirely finished, but when they are, it will be a really great feature within the standard plan. So I press on Upgrade Now. You also get a 50% discount for the first year, so that's really great. Make sure that all your information is correct, choose the right payment method, and click over here to Pay Now. Now, we don't need to download this zip file because it's the exact same plugin. It just goes by your subscription. Then go back to WordPress and press F5 on your keyboard. And then we see over here we have 25,000 visits a month. So we have upgraded our plan. Now we can go to Capabilities. And now we can also activate this built-in screen reader. Now this is really awesome. I'm going to show you that in just a second. If we then scroll down, we can also hide the Elementor logo. White label it. Perfect. And then we press Save Changes. That's basically all there is. Now when I open up my accessibility plugin, you can also see the screen reader over there. So let me click on this one.
Screen reader enabled.
There we
reading
go.
Pace, normal, 1 of 3.
So if I click again.
Unlabeled element.
unlabeled element. That's not very nice.
Button read slow.
This works, read slow. So if I now go to my website, let's put it on the normal speed.
Screen reader enabled, unlabeled element.
And if I now click on somewhere else.
Heading level 2 snow, rain, sun.
You can hear exactly what's going on. So I click over here.
Shipped the same day. Order before 4 p.m. and we ship your order the same day.
This is a really great screen reader. It actually works.
Ladies. Close ladies. Open ladies. Heading level 2 snow, rain, sun. Unpredictable weather ready. Sale, up to 20% off.
And if you navigate now on your website with the tab button on your keyboard.
Link to skip to content. Heading level 3. Order before 4 p.m. and we Heading level 3. Secure payments. Your card information will not be stored on our servers. Heading level 3. Free shipping for orders above $75. You will pay nothing for shipment, our gift for you. Link to an image of white diamond logo.
And when you navigate to your website with the tab on your keyboard, you notice that some things doesn't have any labels. For example, my wishlist icon or my account link, it doesn't have the right labels. So someone with a visual disability cannot hear what this button is all about, and we can improve our website. I think the screen reader option is really great. Also now, you don't see the logo Ally by Elementor. I'm really happy with this accessibility plugin, and for free you get so much. Now it's time for the big surprise giveaway. Elementor has been so kind to give us 10 discount codes so you can get the first year for Pro Plan completely free. How nice is that? To receive a discount code, you just have to be one of all the people that comment inside of this video, create a nice comment, and in the next 30 days from launch of this video, you will make a chance to get one of those free licenses for the first year. So to participate, just place a nice comment below this video. If you have any questions or you just want to say thank you, Matt, drop it down in the comments. I'll always reply. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel if you want to hear more about Elementor and WordPress and all these amazing things. And if you also want to build this beautiful e-commerce website, then just click over here and you will go straight to my 5.5 hours tutorial with free PDF checklist and also all these beautiful stock images completely for free. So go for it, and I hope to see you in the next video.